Okay, time for a really quick Quest 64 stream. Let's just fire it up really quick. So, last night, I thought I was softlocked. I didn't realize the Altail book and jail key were randomized and that I didn't have them. Then I went through the door behind Vages, which I did not know was one way. Then I made a save state in here, and if you try to use wings here, they just don't work. So it seems like a soft lock. But then, this room has a different flag than this room. If we go to wings, go to Limelin, hey look at that, we're out. Now we can go get the Altail book and jail key, and hopefully finish the game. So I did look up the spoiler log, because I did not want to go around every NPC in the game to figure out where the two key items are. So there's the Altail book in Limelin Tavern, and the other should be in a house in Brannock. I don't know which house, so just gonna poke around randomly until I find it. Good afternoon, Irene and ZA. How's it going? So the spoiler log says it's just a house, so it's probably not like the tavern or inn or anything. So I think it's supposed to be from an NPC that normally gives you a gift, but I don't remember which ones give you gifts normally. So I'm just gonna go all around. Oh, there it is. Dark Jail Key. Now we have to run back through the castle, which is kind of annoying, but we already beat the bosses, so it shouldn't be that bad. We can just run from everything. So yeah, I was pretty convinced that I was just softlocked, but for some reason I decided to load up the save again, just maybe play around, see if I could do something, and just happened to use wings in the right place, and poof, I'm out. Very strange that the that area is flagged for not being able to use wings, even with the option in the randomizer to enable wing usage there. So it should be just a straight shot to the end of the game from here. Hopefully this won't take more than, like, an hour. Gotta run through the castle again. And we gotta do Mammon's World and just fight Mammon. Now, if the encounter rate like this keeps up, probably gonna take a little while longer. Of course, I had to have movement down, just enough to keep me from escaping in one turn. Oh, come on. Seriously? You know, as interesting as this run has been, with the grinding for Shilf, and the weird soft lock, and the avalanche at level 1, it's been pretty fun, but honestly I'm just ready for this run to be over. It's kind of outstayed its welcome, I think. I mean, I probably could have just left it as a soft lock, but I don't know, that didn't really seem right. After like 6 hours, I didn't want to just leave it there. Need some sort of conclusion. I am really excited to get started on Final Fantasy V next week though. I know that game way, way, way better than this. And I will be discussing a lot of stuff in that game. I probably played it 30 times total. Now, just today I learned how to do an item dupe glitch in Final Fantasy V. So you can basically get 255 of any item that you can steal. If you have like drink, mix, or throw, also. There's also some way to use control to dupe an item using the ID of an enemy attack that translates into an item ID. I haven't actually looked into that yet, but it seems pretty strong. The downside of that is you need Beastmaster. You know, in a way, this run was actually really lucky, because I randomly decided to go with Wind right when I needed to, because that unlocked Magic Barrier. And if I didn't have Magic Barrier for, Solvering in Royal Hole, I probably never would have gotten out of here without, like, 3-4 hours of grinding. Oh yeah, duping some items can really change Final Fantasy V. I was actually watching a 90% speedrun of the game on GBA, and they dupe like 60 or something Hermes sandals in World 1. That's pretty crazy. They just sold most of them, then killed everything with Zeninage for like the next hour or so. Yeah, they also bought up a stock of shurikens and ninja scrolls. They just basically threw money at everything, and it was pretty much trivial. Okay, finally back at the entrance to Mammon's world. So this time we have the key and the book, so it should let us in, unless I miss something again. There we go, Mammon's world. I think this is the default music for this area, actually. Music's supposed to be randomized. I see the Jigiments are pretty much neutered. I'm guessing they can't even attack. So I will drop an avalanche on them. Yeah, at this point I don't even need to kill any enemies. I just felt like it. Wanted to get some of that satisfying avalanche sound effects. Yeah, I guess we can kill some Ponhades too. Ooh, yeah, they really don't like Avalanche. Choking Heal. Not sure about that name. Let's just see what it does. No idea. Yeah, one of the more annoying parts of randomized spells is a lot of them just seem to do nothing. They all do something, it's just most don't really have any obvious effects. You know, big guy. No, you do a little bit of damage. I can do some damage too. I guess we can drop some rocks on these Rapidashes too. Oh, never mind, they got Magic Barrier, screw that. Yeah, I'm not waiting for that to wear off. Finally back in Melrood. Almost there. I think this is the default music for this area too. Nasty trick in this area is this room is used twice, so it makes you think you're looping around, but no, you just have to go through it twice. There's Shannon. Oh, just instantly teleported me to Mammon's chamber. Okay. Let's make a little save, just to be safe. For some reason, Bishawk just freaks out on the first quick save of the session. That's always really scary the first time. There's our big boy. We've got magic barriers, so this is Mammon. Okay, this should be trivial. Yeah, Avalanche just messes him up something fierce. Oh yeah, that's satisfying. Do whatever you want, Mammon. I've got a very overpowered spell and I'm not afraid to use it. Oop, that is the wrong spell. Ow. You know, I said I wanted this run to be a little more climactic, but just cheesing Mammon like this is pretty anticlimactic. And there he goes, his flesh is decaying. Goodbye, Mammon. You will not be missed. I think this dialogue was not in the original. I think this was added by the randomizer. Unless I'm just hallucinating. Mammon? Who's that? Do you mean Mammon? Well, I killed Mammon, not Mammon. So yeah, that was the Quest 64 randomizer. It's pretty neat. Got a lot of nice features. It includes the French vanilla updates, which just makes the game a little more playable. If you have any interest in Quest 64, even the blind playthrough, I strongly suggest at least doing the French vanilla version. Whoops, didn't mean to press that. But yeah, spell randomization is a really big part of this. Very fun just seeing what spells you get at every level. And when you've played the game quite a bit, you know what's coming, you know which element to invest in, and you know what spell's supposed to look like. But, randomizing the names and the effects and the scaling, that really changes the game almost completely. Oh wow, that stream was even quicker than I thought. It's only been about half an hour. Well, I was trying to think of something else to do for the stream to make it not just like a half-hour stream, but no, I guess that's good enough. Thank you all for coming by. Thank you for watching this very short stream. And stop by next Saturday, probably. I'll be doing a Final Fantasy V Fiesta run. I did a poll on Twitter a while back for what kind of run, and unsurprisingly, Chaos won. So I will be doing a Chaos run of Final Fantasy V Fiesta. That is going to be very fun, I think. So definitely, definitely keep an eye out for that. And for now, I think I'll send you over to fellow Quest 64 liker Sly09. Yeah, thanks again for watching this short little stream. And let's go enjoy Mega Man Battle Network 3 by Sly09. Thanks.